Good morning. Today we'll study about the third chapter, Structure of the Earth. So it means how the earth is formed and what are the different layers of the earth. So as you all know, we call it as a heavenly body in the universe. Our earth is a heavenly body in the universe, and one of the theory called according to Big Bang theory, the earth was made up of molten material that exploded from the hot ball of fire. Gradually, the molten material cooled and solidified, forming a thin hard surface layer called crust, on which we leave the interior of the earth is very hot. It means one of the theory which scientists have approved is Big Bang theory. Based on that, a hot ball of a fire is got exploded and gradually it cooled and solidified, means it become hardened and cooled by forming two layers. One is a thin layer, what we all leave on the earth is called crust, and the other inner layer is very hot. We can't go deeper in the hot. So, and there is one more theory called continental drift theory, where it states how, coming to this picture, it tells how the earth landmass is divided and formed the continent. So it tells the present structure of the earth was different 200 million years ago. There were no continents and oceans. All the landmasses together formed a supercontinent known as Pangaea. Okay, and there was only one water body known as Panthalassa. So only one landmass which is called Pangaea and one water body which is called Panthalassa. And due to internal movements of the earth, the landmass started to divide into pieces like say jigsaw puzzle. These pieces are known as plates and they floated on the liquid rock matter. Gradually, these pieces began to move away from each other, forming continents. So earlier it was only a one landmass which due to internal division and it moved and formed a different continents. Gradually these pieces began to move and form continents. This theory was stated by Alfred Wegener, the scientist name, he is from German, which we call it as continental drift theory. Later, one more theory came. It proved that not only land masses, also ocean bodies move. This theory is named as plate tectonic theory. So one is continental drift theory, which tells about the land mass, and plate tectonic theory, which states about the ocean beds. So in the picture, we can see how the continents, seven continents were at one place earlier. Earlier in the sense 200 million years ago, later it got divided and found seven continents. So coming to the interior of the earth, you can see from the picture it is given different names. Top layer is called crust, middle layer is called mantle, and inner layer is called core. Again, core is divided into two, outer core and inner core. So the earth's interior is made up of three layers, crust, mantle and core. Photographs of this earth taken from space shows continents and ocean of the earth. Below the ocean is the solid floor known as ocean floor. So again, below the ocean there will be a solid floor. The continents and the ocean floor together forms the crust of the earth, and mantle is the second layer and it is made up of rocks rich in iron and other materials. So it says first is a thin layer of a which is called as crust. Second one is mantle, which is having more rich in minerals. Okay, then core is the center of the earth and made up of heavy metals like nickel and iron. Hence this layer is also known as NiFe. Ni is for nickel, it's a symbol, and Fe for iron. It has a scientific name given for nickel and iron. Then coming to the exterior of the earth, The surface of the earth is made up of 29% of the land mass and 71% of the water. So it means 3/4 is of water and 29% is of land. The large land masses are known as continents, which you all know: Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Europe, Antarctica and Australia, which are 7 continents. And other than these, there are small islands scattered across the ocean. The continents are further divided into countries. So, as per this area, Russia is the largest and Vatican City is the smallest country. Coming up to India, it comes up to 7th largest country in the world. Then, the very deep and large water bodies on the earth are divided into 5 oceans, namely Pacific, Atlantic, the Indian, the Arctic and the Antarctic oceans. Besides these oceans, there are small other ocean bodies like sea, river, lakes, ponds, gulf, bays, stream, etc. All these water bodies are useful for us in many ways, and there are home for many water animals. You might have studied in science class how water bodies, means fish, are living in the water. Same way it is called as, and are also a source of water transport, salt and electricity. So water will help us to get a salt and electricity. Then coming up to the surface of the earth change. There are constant changes both inside and outside the surface of the earth. They're known as rapid and slow changes. Slow changes are, we all know, caused by rain, wind, sun, river, seas and glaciers. So the rain comes in the rainy season, wind will be blowing, sun will be directly when we get in summer, rivers, sea, glaciers. They take place outside the surface of the earth and are responsible for changes of earth's surface. So this rain, wind, sun, rivers, seas and glaciers are changing the upper earth surface. The rapid change are the movements in the interior of the earth. They cause volcanic eruptions and earthquakes. From the picture you can see how the volcanoes is coming from inside the earth and towards outside. So we'll study about volcanoes. As we go deeper inside the earth, the temperature keeps on increasing. So in this chapter earlier we told the inside the earth it's still very hot. So it is very high at the core. The high temperature melts. So due to this high temperature, whatever the rocks inside the mountain or below the earth, it gets melted of the earth and forms a molten mass of rocks is called magma. So the rocks which gets melted, we call it as molten mass. So that is called as magma. And also some gases are also present inside the earth. The magma and the gases are forced out through a passage called vent. So when it is going this passage from inside to outside, we call it as vent. The hot magma that is thrown out through the vent is known as lava. So this is vent, and whatever this orange part, it is volcano which is going out, is called magma. When the lava cools down and it turns to a hard rock, gradually the cool and solidified lava builds up to form a mountain or a plateau. So when it comes out of the earth's surface, it forms a mountain kind of a thing. This plateau or a mountain with an opening at its center through which the molten lava, gases and rock pieces are thrown out is called volcano. So this orange part which is coming from inside the earth and it throws lava and gases outside the earth, as well as rock pieces which are melted, that is called volcano. The mouth of the volcano is a funnel shape and is called crater. So this is for the day, and tomorrow we'll study about earthquakes, tsunami, floods and cyclone. So keep reading. Thank you for the day.